Hello, and welcome to this tech tip from Will. In this tech tip, I will look at Windows storage spaces for Windows 8 and Windows 8.1. I will start by giving you an overview of storage spaces and how it works. Next, I will cover the software and hardware requirements that have to be met in order to use storage spaces. I will then run through the different types of storage spaces that can be created, as well as the advantages and disadvantages of each. Next, I will provide a demonstration on how to use storage spaces on my Windows 8.1 computer. And finally, I will talk you through how to move your storage spaces from one computer to another computer. So let's get started. Storage spaces is a brand new feature that was first introduced in Windows 8 and Windows Server 2012 and remains available for Windows 8.1 and Windows Server 2012 R2. Storage spaces, in a nutshell, is a Microsoft technology that allows you to combine multiple hard disks together to create a pool of storage, called a storage pool. For instance, if I were to combine 5 100GB hard disks into a storage pool, this would give me a storage pool of 500GB. It is worth noting at this point that the hard disks you add to the storage pool do not have to be the same size or type. That is, you can create a storage pool that contains a mixture of different hard disks. Later on in this lesson, I will cover this in more detail. Once my storage pool has been created, I am then able to create virtual hard disks of any size from the accumulated disk space. These virtual hard disks, also called storage spaces, are assigned a drive letter, will appear listed in File Explorer, and can be used to store data just like any traditional hard disk on your computer. Depending on the number of physical hard disks you add to the storage pool, storage spaces will, in some cases, allow you to create virtual hard disks that include resilience. When a virtual hard disk has resilience built into it, the data on that virtual hard disk will remain accessible even if one of the physical hard disks from the storage pool were to fail. You can think of resilience in storage spaces as essentially a form of RAID for virtual hard disks. The only downside to this approach is that resilient virtual hard disks will take up more of the disk space in the storage pool. If this seems a little confusing at present, don't worry. I will cover the different types of storage spaces and how resilience works later on in the lesson. Before I do this though, I would first like to point out the different software and hardware requirements that have to be met in order to use storage spaces. First, you have to be running a suitable version of Windows 8 or Windows 8.1. If you are still using Windows 8, you must be running either Windows 8, Windows 8 Pro, or Windows 8 Enterprise. Similarly, if you are using Windows 8.1, you must be running either Windows 8.1, Windows 8.1 Pro, or Windows 8.1 Enterprise. The only editions of Windows which cannot use storage spaces are the Windows RT editions of Windows 8 and Windows 8.1. Next, you need to ensure that the hard disks you use to create your storage pool are a supported disk type. Microsoft has worked very hard to make storage spaces compatible with virtually any type of modern-day hard disk. If you recall from earlier, you are able to mix and match the types of hard disks you use. According to the Microsoft documentation on storage spaces, the following hard disk types are supported: solid-state drives, serial ATA drives, serial-attached SCSI drives, and even external USB drives. One recommendation that Microsoft does make if you are using USB drives is to use USB 3 drives for maximum performance. However, if this is not possible, older USB 2 drives, although slower, are still supported. You may be wondering at this point exactly how many hard disks can be added to a storage pool. This is a good question, but unfortunately the answer is poorly documented, and it seems that nobody, not even Microsoft, has the answer. However, Microsoft has acknowledged that the technology has been successfully tested with hundreds of hard disks, so it would appear that the upper limit is more likely to be determined by your computer hardware. The last requirement to discuss concerns the controller cards for your hard disks. If any of the hard disk controllers in your computer have RAID capability built in, it is important that this functionality is disabled. This is because Storage Spaces uses its own built-in version of RAID in order to create resilient storage spaces. Attempting to implement and manage RAID at both the hardware and software layers can cause problems. So be sure to set all of your disk controllers to a non-RAID configuration. Now that all of the requirements are covered, I will now discuss the different types of storage spaces that can be created. There are four types of storage spaces that can be created from a storage pool. The first is a simple storage space. A simple storage space requires just one physical hard disk to be added to the storage pool. When data is saved to a simple storage space, the data is written to the physical hard disks in the storage pool using a technique called striping. If there is just one hard disk in the storage pool, when data is saved to the storage space, all of the data is written to the one hard disk. However, in cases where there are more than one disk, the data is striped across the hard disks. That is, instead of being saved whole, the data is broken down into smaller sized chunks, and these chunks of data are then saved to different hard disks. The main benefit of using a simple storage space is increased read performance. That is, if a file that has been striped across multiple hard disks is later opened, the hard disks in the storage pool will work together to rebuild the file, as opposed to one hard disk having to rebuild it alone. The main drawback to simple storage spaces, however, is that there is no resilience. This means that if any one of the hard disks in the storage pool were to fail, the storage space will also fail, and all data is lost. The second type of storage space is a two-way mirror storage space. A two-way mirror storage space requires at least two physical hard disks to be added to the storage pool. In a two-way mirror, data is written to the physical hard disks in the storage pool using a technique called mirroring. When data is mirrored, it is essentially written twice. Each copy of the data is then saved to a different hard disk in the storage pool, giving you two identical copies of the data stored on two separate hard disks. This provides good resilience for the storage space, as if one of the hard disks in the pool were to fail, the data is still accessible from the surviving hard disk. The failed hard disk can then be replaced with a new hard disk and the mirror re-established. Two-way mirror storage spaces can tolerate one hard disk failure. Of course, the downside to creating a two-way mirror is that the storage space will essentially take up twice the amount of disk space from the storage pool. That is, for every gigabyte of data you save to the storage space, 2 gigabytes of disk space is required from the storage pool. In cases where the storage pool has more than two physical hard disks, the data is randomly saved to different disks to ensure it is properly spread out. Another downside to two-way mirrors is that write performance is degraded. This is because Windows is constantly having to save 2 copies of every piece of data that is saved to the storage space. The next type of storage space is a three-way mirror storage space. A three-way mirror storage space requires at least 5 physical hard disks to be added to the storage pool. In a three-way mirror, data is written to the physical hard disks in the storage pool in such a way that there is 3 complete copies of the data being stored on separate hard disks. Three-way mirrors provide excellent resilience, since there are 3 complete copies of the data. Three-way mirrors are able to tolerate up to 2 hard disk failures from the storage pool. Of course, this does come with a trade-off of disk space and write performance. Since there are 3 copies of the same data being stored on different hard disks, the data will essentially take up 3 times the amount of disk space. That is, for every gigabyte of data you save to the storage space, 3 gigabytes of disk space is required from the storage pool. Write performance is also significantly degraded in a three-way mirror, since Windows has to save 3 copies of the data. For this reason, I would recommend that you only create a three-way mirror if the data you are storing is extremely critical and cannot be lost under any circumstances. Otherwise, creating a three-way mirror could be overkill for your needs. The last type of storage space is a parity storage space. A parity storage space requires at least 3 physical hard disks to be added to the storage pool. With a parity storage space, data is written to the physical hard disks in the storage pool using a technique called striping with parity. As with the simple storage space, when data is saved to a parity storage space, it is broken into chunks. These chunks of data are then striped across the hard disks in the storage pool. The only difference with the parity storage space is that when data is written, additional data, called parity information, is also written. Parity information is essentially a copy of the broken up data stored on one disk. In this example, you can see that the data saved to the parity storage space has been broken into chunks and the pieces saved to hard disks 1 and 2. Notice, however, that the third hard disk did not receive a chunk of data. Instead, parity information is written to this disk. The parity information is essentially a complete copy of the data that was striped across disks 1 and 2. Note what happens when I add more data. On this occasion, the data is broken up and the pieces are this time saved to hard disks 1 and 3, and the parity information is saved to disk 2. If yet more data is added, the parity information is this time saved to disk 1. Striping with parity ensures that both the data and the parity information is spread out over multiple physical hard disks. This provides good resilience for the storage space because if one of the hard disks in the pool were to fail, the data on that disk is still accessible from the parity information on the surviving disks. The failed hard disk can then be replaced with a new disk and, using the parity information on the surviving disks, the data can be reconstructed. Parity storage spaces can tolerate 1 hard disk failure. The main drawback to parity storage spaces, however, is that write performance is degraded due to having to calculate and write parity information. Once you have decided on the type of storage space you'd like to create, the next decision you need to make is the type of provisioning you would like your storage space to use. Windows 8 and Windows 8.1 storage spaces both support the use of thick and thin provisioning. When a storage space uses thick provisioning, all of the disk space required for the storage space is allocated when the storage space is first created. To visualize this better, take for example a 500GB storage pool made up of 5 100GB disks. If I were to create a 200 gigabyte simple storage space, 200 gigabytes of disk space from the storage pool will be allocated all at once to the storage space, leaving 300 gigabytes of disk space in the storage pool to be allocated to another storage space. Simply put, when thick provisioning is used, you can only create the storage space if you physically have the disk space available in the storage pool. With thin provisioning, disk space is allocated to the storage space from the storage pool only when it is needed. If we again take our 500 gigabyte storage pool as an example, if I were to again create a 200 gigabyte simple storage space, the storage space will be created, but the storage pool will not allocate the disk space to it all at once. Instead, storage spaces will allocate only the amount of disk space required. For example, if I were to save a 2GB file to the storage space, only 2GB of disk space from the pool will be allocated. Thin provisioning also allows you to create storage spaces that are larger than the amount of physical hard disk space in the storage pool. For instance, I could create a 2TB storage space from a 500GB storage pool if I wanted to. When this is the case, as the data added to the storage space increases and the disk space in the pool starts to become scarce, Windows will warn you of this and prompt you to add another disk to the pool and increase its capacity. As you can see, there is a lot to Windows storage spaces. Now that we have discussed the requirements, types of storage spaces, and provisioning methods available, I will now change over to my Windows 8.1 computer to demonstrate how to use storage spaces. Before I demonstrate how to use storage spaces, I will first open Disk Management so that I can show you the number of physical disks I have installed in this computer. As you can see, Disk Management is reporting that there are, in fact, 6 hard disks of varying sizes installed in this computer. These are Disk 0, Disk 1, Disk 2, Disk 3, Disk 4, and Disk 5. Disk 0 is the hard disk which contains my Windows 8.1 operating system, and Disk 1 is currently being used as a data drive. At present, Disks 2 to 5 are spares and are not currently in use and have not even been formatted with a file system. Now that we know the number of hard disks installed in my system, I will close Disk Management and return to my desktop. To access Windows storage spaces, first open Control Panel and select the System and Security category. From the list of tools, select the Storage Spaces option. This will open the Manage Storage Spaces page. When the tool is opened for the first time, there is not an awful lot you can do with it. To create a storage pool from the hard disks in our computer, click the Create a New Pool and Storage Space link. This will open the Select Drives to Create a Storage Pool page. From here, Windows will list all of the hard disks in the computer which can be used to create a storage pool. Remember, the hard disk that contains your Windows operating system cannot be used to create a storage pool. This is why only 5 of my 6 hard disks are listed. Selecting the hard disks you wish to add to the storage pool is simply a matter of ticking the checkbox to the left of the hard disk. However, in order to add a hard disk, the disk must not be formatted with a file system. Fortunately, Windows will separate the hard disks into 2 categories: unformatted drives and formatted drives, so you can clearly see which of your disks are suitable. As you can see, 4 of my hard disks are unformatted. The 5th disk, however, is formatted. Although I am still able to select my formatted disk and add it to the pool, Notice that Windows will display a warning message stating that all data on the disk will be deleted before the disk is added. If this is the case on your system, be sure that you back up any important data on your formatted disks before you add them to the pool. For now, I will create a storage pool using 4 out of my 5 eligible disks. When you are ready to create the storage pool, click the Create Pool button. At this point, Windows will prepare the drives and will create the storage pool. This should only take a moment to complete. Once the storage pool has been created, we will be prompted to create a storage space from the available disk space in the pool. The first configuration we have to make is to choose a name for the storage space. You can name the storage space anything you like. Since a storage space is essentially a virtual hard disk, I will name my storage space VDisk1. Next, I need to assign the storage space a drive letter to make it accessible in Windows. To do this, simply choose an available drive letter from the drop-down list. In my case, I will select to use drive letter E. The next option, File System, is only available if you are using Windows 8.1. From here, I can choose which file system I would like to use to format my storage space, either NTFS or REFS. If you are using Windows 8, all storage spaces are formatted with the NTFS file system. However, for Windows 8.1, you are able to choose between NTFS and REFS for mirrored storage spaces only. Simple and parity storage spaces can still only use NTFS. Notice that you cannot use the older FAT or FAT32 file systems. To keep things simple for now, I will leave this on the default NTFS. Next, I need to choose a resiliency type. This is essentially the type of storage space you'd like to create. From the drop-down list, you can select Simple, No Resiliency, Two-Way Mirror, Three-Way Mirror, or Parity. These are the types of storage spaces we discussed earlier. Once you have selected a storage space type, notice, underneath, that Windows will remind you how many physical hard disks must be added to your storage pool in order to create the storage space. Since I have added 4 hard disks to my storage pool, I am able to create a simple, two-way mirror, or parity storage space. I cannot create a three-way mirror, since this requires 5 physical hard disks, and if I select this option, I cannot create the storage space, since the Create Storage Space button at the bottom is greyed out. For now, I will leave this on the Simple, No Resiliency option. The last options we have are the sizing options. The total pool capacity is the amount of disk space the hard disks in the storage pool add up to. In my case, this is 397 gigabytes. The available pool capacity is the amount of disk space from the pool which has not yet been allocated to a storage space. Since I have yet to create a single storage space, all of the pool capacity is still available for use. The maximum size field allows you to choose how large you would like to make the storage space. Personally, I like to use thick provisioning, so I will enter a value of 100 gigabytes. Thin provisioning is automatically used if the size of the storage space is larger than the total pool capacity. The Include Resiliency option is the amount of disk space the storage space will take up when you take the resiliency into account. Since simple storage spaces do not use resiliency, the storage space, including resiliency, is still 100 gigabytes. If, however, I were to change the resiliency type to a two-way mirror, you will notice that the size of the storage space, including resiliency, has now increased to 200 gigabytes. However, if one of the hard disks in my storage pool were to fail, the data on my storage space will still be accessible. When you are ready to create the storage space, click the Create Storage Space button. Windows will start to create the storage space. This should only take a moment to complete. Once the storage space has been created, if I open File Explorer, notice that my VDisk1 storage space is now appearing as a drive on my computer. If I open my VDisk1 drive, notice that I am able to save data into the drive, just as if it were a regular hard disk. I will now close File Explorer and return to Storage Spaces. To manage your storage pool and storage spaces, you can use the Manage Storage Spaces screen. At the top of the screen, notice that we are able to see, in a graphical representation, how much disk capacity is remaining from the storage pool. In my case, I can see that I am currently using approximately 3.5 GB of my 397 GB storage pool. Below this, in the Storage Spaces section, I can see all of the storage spaces that have been created from this storage pool. At present, I only have the one storage space, named VDisk1, which has been configured as a two-way mirror, and will be allowed to grow to 100 gigabytes in size. One feature that I particularly like is that I can see how much disk space this particular storage space is using from the storage pool as a whole, so you can easily see where your disk space is being consumed. You may have also noticed that Windows will provide you with a status overview of your storage space. As you can see, this storage space has a status of OK, meaning there are currently no problems. Below the Storage Spaces section, we have the Physical Drive section. If I expand this out, you can see all of the physical hard disks that are contributing disk space to my storage pool. From here, I can see how much disk space the hard disks are providing to the storage pool and how much of this space has already been consumed as a percentage. As with the storage space above, Windows will provide you with a status overview for each of the hard disks. Currently, all of my disks have a status of OK, meaning they are present and in good health. To demonstrate how these statuses work, I will now remove one of the hard disks that is contributing disk space to my storage pool. I have now removed one of the hard disks from my Windows 8.1 computer. Notice that the status of one of my hard disks has changed to warning. Windows has detected that one of the hard disks in my storage pool is no longer present. This could be because it has become disconnected, or has perhaps failed. Also note that the status of my VDisk1 storage space has also changed to warning, and that the storage space is now operating with reduced resilience. Despite this, if I open File Explorer, you can see that my VDisk1 drive is still accessible. If you recall from earlier, I set this storage space up as a two-way mirror, meaning I am able to tolerate one hard disk failure, so the data is still accessible from the other disks in my storage pool. If you are using storage spaces with resilience and a hard disk in the storage pool fails, you should replace it as soon as possible to avoid the risk of data loss. To do this, I will first click the Change Settings button at the top of the Manage Storage Spaces screen to give me access to the hard disk options. I will now click the Remove button next to the missing hard disk and will confirm the removal by clicking the Remove Drive button. After Windows has removed the disk from the storage pool, notice that the storage pool capacity has been reduced. In this particular case, you will also notice that the status of my storage space and of my hard disks has returned to OK. This is because Windows has redistributed the data that was previously on the failed hard disk among the remaining disks in the pool. Since my storage pool now has 3 physical hard disks and my mirrored storage space only requires 2 disks for resilience, the data on my VDisk 1 storage space is no longer at risk. I will now demonstrate how to add a new hard disk to my storage pool. At the top of the Manage Storage Spaces screen, click the Add Drives link. Windows will display any hard disks it has found which are not currently part of the storage pool. If you recall from earlier, when I first created my storage pool, I chose to add only 4 of my 5 eligible disks. This is the 5th hard disk I chose not to add to the pool. I will confirm the disk is selected and will click the Add Drives button. Windows will add the disk to the storage pool, which should only take a moment. Now that the replacement hard disk has been added to my storage pool, notice that the total pool capacity has again increased. You can also see that the new hard disk is now listed in the physical drive section. The last demonstration I would like to perform is how to create another storage space. To create another storage space, at the top of the Manage Storage Spaces screen, click the Create a Storage Space link. This will open the familiar looking screen for creating storage spaces. I will now create a new storage space called VDisk 2. Assign it a drive letter of F, and will format it with the NTFS file system. In this case, I will select to create a parity storage space of 500 gigabytes. Notice that when I take the resilience into account, the amount of disk space required by this storage space is 750 gigabytes. Although there is no way my storage pool can accommodate this completely, notice that I am still allowed to create the storage space. When this is the case, Windows will automatically use thin provisioning for this storage space and will only allocate disk space when it is required. As the storage space grows in size and the amount of disk space in the pool becomes scarce, Windows will prompt you to add an additional hard disk to the storage pool. Notice that my VDisk 2 storage space is now listed on the Manage Storage Spaces screen. Furthermore, if I open File Explorer, you will also see that the storage space is available as a 500 GB drive on my computer. Now that I have demonstrated how to create and manage storage pools and storage spaces, the final topic I would like to cover is how to move a storage pool from one computer to another computer. For instance, imagine that you have a Windows 8 computer. On this computer, you added 4 hard disks and created a storage pool and storage spaces. Let's then imagine that you purchase a brand new computer and would like to transfer your storage pool and storage spaces over to the new computer. This is a relatively simple thing to do. First, you need to ensure that the new computer is running a suitable version of either Windows 8 or Windows 8.1. Remember, storage spaces is new to Windows 8 and is not supported by older operating systems such as Windows 7 or Windows Vista. Moving the storage pool and storage spaces is simply a matter of removing all of the hard disks that make up the pool from the old computer and installing them into the new computer. Remember, the hard disk that contains the operating system cannot be included in a storage pool, so this disk does not have to be transferred. Once the hard disks have been successfully moved, Windows will detect that the hard disks are part of a storage pool, and the storage spaces will again become accessible on the new computer. This concludes this tech tip on Windows storage spaces for Windows 8 and Windows 8.1. I hope that you have enjoyed this tech tip and found it useful. For more tech tips from Will, please feel free to browse our YouTube channel. And don't forget to show your support by liking our videos and subscribing to our channel. Many thanks, and we'll see you on the next tech tip.